Hello learners, I would like to first of all start by congratulating all the students who have qualified for this foundational level program and have chosen computational thinking to move forward with. Let's get into this question. So the question states that the following pseudo code is executed using the scores table. What will be the values of A and B? What will the values of A and B represent at the end of execution? So in the first line, we initialize an empty dictionary to the variable D, and then we enter this while loop, and we see that while table 1 has more rows, we read the first row X in table 1, and then we enter this if statement. So what does the if statement say? It says that if is key D comma X dot city town. So from the lecture videos that we've seen, we know that isKey is basically a function that checks if this particular city or town is it already present in the dictionary D. So we see if this city or town is already present in D. Now if so, then we enter this nested statement and we see if the marks assigned to this city is it greater than the current mark in mathematics. If so, then we assign this mathematics marks to this particular city. So we have seen this logic before. It's same as saying that if a min value is greater than a said x value, then we assign the x value to this min. So that's what we're trying to find out, basically the minimum value. Now if this city or town is not there in D, then we'd not enter this if statement. Instead we go to this else statement and we create a new city. So basically that new city is going to be your key and the max marks, say 55 or something, is your value. So now you have a new value here with where the key is your city and the value is your marks and maths. Now moving forward, once this while loop is done and you have your entire dictionary ready with you, so you move into this second block of code where you see that your value of A is assigned to 0 and B is assigned to 100. Now we enter this for each loop, for each Y in keys of D. Now as we all know that a dictionary is made of key value pairs where you have a key and a key and then a colon and then your value, say your marks in math 75 and then a person B got something like 82 and a person C got something like 55 and then you have a person D who say got 75 again. Okay, so these are your four key value pairs, and what Y does is it iterates through each of your keys. So in each iteration it takes the value A, B, C or D. Now getting into this for each loop, we see that if B is equal to D of Y, which means in the first iteration your value of B is equal to 100, your A is equal to 0, that's all just to be noted here. Now if B is equal to D of Y, so in the first iteration you know that Y takes the value of A and the marks at A is 75. So D of A basically points to this value 75 and it is compared with B. Now we know that it's not equal, so it does not enter this if statement, and now it checks the second if statement. Yeah. So it checks the second if statement and it sees if b is greater than d of y. So what's happening here? Now in the second if statement, it checks if your value of b, which is 100 in the first iteration, is it greater than 75? Now it is greater than 75, so it enters this if statement. It initializes the value of a to 1. So now your a is no longer 0, it is 1. And your value of b, your value of b is now assigned to d of y. So here your value of b actually now becomes 75. And then you go into your second iteration. So let me just erase this so it's more clear. Okay, now in your second iteration, your value of b is 75 and your value of a is 1. And then you go into the second iteration. Here y takes now the value of b, and you see that the d of b is actually 82. D of b is 82. So now going to this iteration, we see that neither is 82 equal to 75 nor is it greater than 75. So no value gets updated here. So we see that in the first iteration, we can get a sense that b can only go lower, which means that we are actually finding out the lowest mark in mathematics. So let's confirm this. So now in the third iteration, y takes the value of c. So here your c is 55. Now is 55 greater than 75? Is it equal to 75? No. Is 75 greater than 55? Yes, it is. Which means now b takes the value of 55. And a is still 1. A is still 1. So what is a doing here? A is basically keeping a track or keeping a count of the number of cities where the lowest marks were achieved. Because a only increments if the lowest marks was already present in the dictionary. Only then does a increment. So that means what we find out here is from the given options, there is only one option that matches our criteria, where a is the, let me just clear my screen here. Yeah, where a is the number of cities where students have scored the lowest marks in mathematics. And there is only one option B that actually matches the criteria, that is the option number C, where it says that B is the lowest number, lowest marks in mathematics. So we can see that in the first question, the correct answer to the question is option number C, that is A is the number of cities where students score the lowest marks in mathematics and B is the lowest marks in mathematics. Thank you, students.